problem, Norma.
Why do you have to answer the phone like that? What happened to hello?
Fine, hello. What's the problem?
Somebody torched my house. They burned it down to the ground. Now can I check
they
in?
They torched your house?
Yeah.
Your house? Sheriff Romero, the big daddy of White Pine Bay. I mean, what kind of crazy lunatic would torch your house?
Yeah,
I mean,
question.
If I had torched your house, I'd be getting the hell out of town because I figured you'd be coming for my ass.
Well, that's where we're gonna come.
I heard there was funnel cake.
Come on, Mrs. Sheriff, I'll set you up.
Sheriff Romero wanted to see what we're doing. I guess you're a little interested in design?
Wouldn't put it that way.
Norma.
You scared me. You shouldn't sneak up on somebody like that.
I didn't know walking down the sidewalk constitutes sneaking up on somebody.
Oh, you know what? Chick's here with the window. I'm just going to help him.
Chick?
Yeah, he's just got the window.
What did he say to you?
She said, I got the window. I could use some help unloading it.
Oh. That gets a little bit compromised when Sheriff Bulldog is standing on my porch.
A few moments later.
Hi, hon.
Hey.
Hi, I miss you.
Yeah, me too.
Why haven't you answered any of my calls?
Because I don't want to talk to you. Or
whatever. You want to act like a third grade girl right now? Fine.
So that looks delicious.
Good.
It's a lot.
Well, you're a big guy. I'm like big and tallish. Not. Well.
Norma.
Oh my God.
You get out of here, right?
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here?
I was pressing the flesh with some council members, and I see a figure sneaking along in the shadows, and I followed it, and here you are. I don't know why. You need to get out of here.
No. Do you know what's going on inside there? Do you know what kind of people these are?
Incredibly wealthy people doing whatever the hell they feel.
Okay, what jerk invented the phone?
What kind of name is Gunner anyway?
A stupid one.
Sleep well, Mrs. Romero.
I'm keeping my name.
You can go home now, Norma.
And I want a pool. It doesn't have to be anything fancy, say 20 by 40 feet with a jacuzzi. And of course a fence so that it's safe.
Where are my clothes?
Your clothes? You mean the ones you left in a heap all over your room?
Yeah, those clothes.
They're upstairs, I washed them.
Together in heart.
You can skip this part. We know all this.
She's just nervous, God.
Together in heart, together.
Are you kidding?
Norma.
You're gonna patronize me over this? I've done your laundry.
We're just gonna talk and make sure we're not missing anything.
Dude, what are you saying? Are you saying that we all have things hidden inside us? Secrets we don't want anyone to know, things that other people might know and hold over your head, even though you personally have done nothing to them.
I think he's just talking about the window, Norma.
And put your damn gun down like you're gonna shoot me. That'll be the day.
I hate you.
Well, I hate you too, so what?
Well, isn't that what happens at most motels? That the motel owner doesn't come into your room and pick up your clothes and do your laundry for you?
I know you.
How does that matter?
Of course it matters. Come upstairs, it's gonna
no,
get
I'm
infected.
Not, that's fine.
It's not fine, it's dirty and you need to clean it up. Chef, they want a picture with you.
Oh, okay. All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, Big Shot.
Well, sometimes at night, you have your light on the bedroom. You can see right through those curtains.
You can?
Yeah. All right.
I need insurance. You have insurance. So I thought maybe you could marry me. It's not like you're doing anything else. Please, it would just be on paper. I'm not asking for an actual marriage.
You are a mess.
Can you just drop me off at my house?
No way. You need looking after.
No, I'm fine. I won't put you out. Just drop me off at my house. But...
Shut up. You're going off to work and kissing me, and it's like I'm watching a movie, but it's not a movie.
It's not a movie. Don't screw it up.
And now there's a couple of stoners sleeping in there. God knows what they trapped in with them.
Sort of funny that you went to the service industry. Don't seem very keen on serving anybody.
I'm as keen as I need to be.
I'm an elected official. I need people to trust me, okay? I'm not supposed to be cutting legal corners and marrying
somebody. Have they met you?
Funny.
Did Annika Johnson have anything on her when she died?
Clothes.
Don't be a smartass.
I'm not being a smartass. I whacked the shit out of the real estate agent who sold me this house when I found out that I couldn't unload it. I did it with my purse. It felt great. Oh, my God.
What?
You smiled. I thought your face was paralyzed.
Pretty sure I didn't smile.
God, you're contrary.
Oh, and you're not. Can you lean into me a little? Maybe we've had physical contact before this moment.
This is weird. Oh, like what? Like he digs up a couple of more dead people and puts them in my bed?
Yeah, like that. Night, Norma.
What do you have the magical ability to make me feel calm?
Something I gotta tell you. I'm actually magical. I'm a unicorn.
You're trying to say that you have something? I mean, is that it? Because if you did, that really wouldn't be good for you. I mean, I might have to burn you down to the ground, you know?
You lost your mind?
And maybe it's irrelevant. Listen to me.
You're here to see me because...
I need you to get him out.
Norma, I'm not magical. I've got nothing to do with Willamette.
Yeah, but you're a sheriff. Don't you know someone? I mean, can't you just pull some strings, threaten someone, beat someone up in the parking lot? Alex, don't start.
Hey, I am not dead. I am alive. You're alive. Whoopee.
Who are you going to put in that boat with you?
Well, maybe you and I get a Norma and we leave her on the ship.
No, Alex, don't make jokes. That's inappropriate.
Then why are you here?
I'm not here for that. Do you remember when I first met you? On the porch in the motel that night?
Yeah, my heart stopped. Mostly because I thought you were going to arrest me.
No, I missed that opportunity.
A unicorn?
What?
Did you say that?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Did you say you were a unicorn?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You did!
Yeah, I'm fine. Why wouldn't I be fine?
So I thought maybe because you came to my house to ask me to marry you for insurance, maybe you might not be fine.
Yeah, we're all good here. Thanks for stopping by.
Call you by your name. It's a little stupid at this point. Hey, Sheriff Romero. I've never seen you in a suit.
Good morning.
Very good morning.
I need to speak to Sheriff Romero right away, please. It's a matter of life and death.
What is your name, please?
Are you kidding me? You don't know my name?
Norma Louise Bates.
We need to talk. He told me.
I got people I see.
Oh, that's cryptic. Is it anyone I know?
Yeah, possibly. It's a small town.
I want names. I guess I'll see you around.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I'm about to die. Okay.
Oh, I'm about to die.